Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome in our biology session. So we are discussing the lesson that is microorganism, friends and foe. In this we are discussing about the useful microorganism. Some uses of the microorganism already we have seen. So today we will see the next use of microorganism is what? That microorganisms also used to increase the soil fertility. So let's see how the microorganism increases the soil fertility. So in our previous chapter we have discussed about the rhizobium bacteria. So this rhizobium bacteria lives in the leguminous plant, living in the root nodules of the leguminous plants. And this rhizobium bacteria helps to absorb the atmospheric nitrogen and convert it into simple soluble form, that is what, in a nitrate. Okay, they convert it into simple soluble form of nitrogen, that is in the form of nitrate. They convert the atmospheric nitrogen into the simple form, that is in the form of nitrate. Okay, and with the help of this nitrate, the fertility of the soil is also get increased. Also, when we cut the plants or when we cut the crops, that time the roots of the crops remain in the soil as it is. After harvesting, when the root nodules get decomposed, that root nodules contain the nitrates, and that nitrate gets mixed in the soil and it helps to increase the nitrogen, or it helps to increase the amount of nitrogen in the soil. With the help of these rhizobium bacteria, there are some other bacteria and blue-green algae helps to increase the soil fertility by increasing the nitrogen fixation, by doing the nitrogen fixation in the soil. So in this way, some bacteria, there are certain bacteria and the blue-green algae is also there, which helps to fix the nitrogen in the soil. So in this way, all these microbes are called as what? Nitrogen fixer, natural biological nitrogen fixer. So these rhizobium bacteria, blue-green algae are called as biological nitrogen fixer. Okay, so in this way we have discussed about the next use, what? That is increasing soil fertility. Now the next one we'll discuss, that is cleaning the environment. How the microorganism helps to clean the environment. So as we know, there are the certain bacteria or there are the microbes are present which helps to decompose the organic material of plants and animal, organic waste material of plants and animal, and decompose them, and the valuable compounds or valuable things from that organic matter again get mixed into the soil. So in this way, they helps to clean the dead organic material from the soil. And if the microbes will be not there on the earth, then what will be happen? All these dead parts of the plants and the animal will get collected on the earth and it will cover whole earth. So in this way, the microorganisms helps to clean the environment by decompose that organic matter of plants and animals. Also, there are the certain bacteria which helps to decompose the sewage and the waste material from the water, from the wastewater. So in this way, this is the natural method to keep the water clean. So in this way, what we can say, that microbes also helps to clean the environment. Next one, we discuss some other uses of microbes. So there are the certain microbes which helps in the leather and the jute industry. Also, as we know, we have seen in our previous class, that is what, rumination process. There are the certain ruminants, they are eating the grass, and in that ruminants there are the certain bacteria are present. That bacteria helps to digest the cellulose. So in this way, the certain microbes can help to digest the cellulose in the ruminants. Also, some microbes, certain bacteria are used to produce the biogas, and that biogas can be used as a fuel. Okay, so in this way, there are the so many uses of the microbes. So up till now, we have discussed about the useful microbes, how the microorganisms are useful for us. But now we will discuss about the other side of the microbes, that is what, we'll discuss about the harmful microorganism.
So up till now we have discussed about the useful microorganisms, but these microorganisms are also harmful in a many ways. So now we will discuss about how the microorganisms are harmful in a different way. So first one, we will discuss about these microorganisms causes the communicable disease in human being, animals and plants. So first we will discuss that how the microorganism causes the communicable disease in human being. So there are the different microorganisms. Some are useful to us and some are harmful to us. But the microorganisms which are harmful, or the microorganism which causes certain diseases, that microorganisms are called as what? Pathogens. What is it by pathogens? The microorganisms which causes the diseases, or which is responsible to cause the different diseases, that microorganisms are called as pathogen, or also it is called as germs. So with the help of these pathogens, or with the help of these germs, different diseases are getting spread in human beings. So let's discuss which are the diseases are getting spread in the human beings with the help of these different microbes. So there are so many diseases are getting spread in the human being with the help of the microorganism, but that diseases are called as what? Communicable diseases. Microorganisms called communicable diseases. So what is meant by communicable diseases? The diseases which are get transmitted from the infected person to the healthy person from or with the help of the air, water, food, insect or animals, or from the physical contact, or we can say that from direct contact, then that diseases are called as what? Communicable diseases. Okay. So what is meant by communicable disease? The disease which can get spread from one person to another person, that diseases are called as what? Communicable diseases. So there are the different types of the communicable diseases are there. There are the so many different types of the diseases. We can say that what? Chicken pox is there, common cold is there, also we can say that cholera is there, typhoid is there. All these are the different examples of communicable diseases which can get spread from one person to another person. But how these diseases are getting spread from one person to another person, from infected person to the healthy person? So there are the certain ways, by that ways our diseases are getting spread from infected person to healthy person. So let's see which are the different ways. First one is that through air. So the communicable diseases can get spread through the air. Certain diseases like common cold is there, pneumonia is there, tuberculosis is there. All these diseases are spread with the help of the air. But how they are getting spread with the help of the air? So the person, those who are having, or the infected person, those who are having the tuberculosis or the pneumonia or the common cold, if that infected person sneezes or coughs in the air, then what happens? Whenever that person is sneezing, with the help of the sneezing, so many droplets get spread in the air, and that's a droplet contain the moisture, that moisture contain the germs of these diseases. So that moisture contain the germs, and that germs get spread, or that pathogens get spread into the air. When that healthy person will get breathe, or when the healthy person is doing the breathing in that infected air, then that germs will get enter into the body of healthy person, and that healthy person will also get infected from that same diseases. So for this reason only, whenever we are doing the sneezing and whenever we are coughing, we should cover our nose and mouth properly. So in this way, what will happen? The germs will not get entered in the air and the diseases will not get spread. We can try to stop in this way communicable disease. Now we will discuss about the next way. In this way also the communicable diseases are getting spread, that is what? Through the air, with the help of the water that we are drinking. So there are the so many waterborne diseases are there. There are the certain diseases which are causes due to the contaminated water, and that diseases we can say that what? Waterborne diseases. So for example, we can say that, so the diseases like cholera, typhoid, jaundice, hepatitis B, polio, all these other diseases are getting spread with the help of the water. So that all diseases or these diseases, germs or the pathogens enters into the healthy person's body and that healthy person can also get contaminated. So during the rainy season or whenever there is any natural calamities there, that time the government is advise us to drink the boiled water. So in this case we have to drink the boiled water, or all the time we have to drink the boiled water, because boiling of the water kills all the germs present in the water and make it pure for the drinking. So in this way the water is also one way with the help of the communicable diseases are getting spread. Next one is that the food. So different types of the microbes are present in the soil. We can say that protozoa, spores of fungi, all these things are present in the soil. Through the soil it enters into our food. So that is the reason the fruits and the vegetables before eating we should wash it properly to remove all the germs present on that. And if we eat it, then we can get the foodborne diseases. We can get suffer from the certain types of the communicable diseases. Next way is there, with the help of the certain insects and the animals also the communicable diseases are getting spread. So let's discuss about them, how the insects and the animals helps to carry or helps to transport the different communicable diseases. So there are the certain insects and the animals that insects and animals helps to transfer the disease from one person to another person. It means what happens, they carry the disease causing microorganisms from one person to another person, and that organism or that insects or animals are called as what? Vector. Okay, what is mean by vector? Vectors carry the disease causing microbes from an infected person to healthy person and cause diseases. Okay, so this vector itself doesn't cause any disease, it just transport the germs from infected person to healthy person. So there are the certain animals and the insects are there which carry disease causing microbes from infected person to healthy person, and that animals or insects are called as what? Vector. So this is the definition of the vector. What is it by vector? Vectors carry the disease causing microbes from an infected person to healthy person and cause diseases. Okay, so there are the different vectors are present in our environment. We can say that some example like what? House fly and mosquitoes. So as we know, the house flies are present everywhere. That house flies are sitting anywhere. They are sitting on the rubbish things also, and they are sitting on the food materials also. So whenever the house fly sits on the any waste material or on the rubbish thing, then what happens? Whatever the germs are present on that waste material, all these germs are get stuck to the legs of the house fly, and also it gets stuck to the mouth portion of the house fly. And that same house fly, whenever it is seated on the food material, then that house fly releases all the germs which are stuck to its mouth and the legs into that food atom. And in this way, if we consume that food atom, then we are getting suffer from the different diseases. Okay, so in this way what we can say, that what? House fly helps to transport the disease causing microbes from one infected person to healthy person. So in this way the house fly is also the one type of vector. So in this way the house fly can contaminated the food and the water, and if we'll consume that contaminated food and the water, then we'll get suffer from the diseases. Like we can get suffer from the different diseases. We can say that cholera, typhoid, tuberculosis, dysentery, all these are the diseases are getting spread with the help of these house fly. So to stop the communicable disease, to stop the spread of the communicable disease, we should avoid to eat the uncovered food. We should eat the healthy and the fresh food. Now the next one vector we will discuss about, that is what? Mosquitoes. Okay, So there are the certain mosquitoes which helps to transport the pathogens or to help to transport the disease causing microbes from infected person to the healthy person. We can say that the female Anopheles mosquito sucks the blood. Okay, the female Anopheles mosquito sucks the blood, and while sucking the blood, it leaves the plasmodium, that is one type of protozoa. It leaves the plasmodium in the person's body, and that plasmodium causes the malaria. So in this way, what we can say that what? Anopheles, female Anopheles mosquito helps to cause the malaria disease. Also, we can say that one more example of the mosquito, Aedes female mosquito. Aedes mosquito helps to transport the virus of the dengue, okay, or dengue virus will be transported from the one person to healthy person. So in this way, these mosquitoes can also act as a vector. So to stop the spreading of the communicable disease with the help of because of these mosquitoes, what we can do on our label, what we can do that we should stop the breeding places, or we should destroy the breeding places of the mosquitoes. Do not allow or don't allow any stagnant water in your surrounding. If it is there, then destroy it and keep your surrounding clean. Okay, so if we'll keep the surrounding clean and dry, then we can stop the breeding of the mosquitoes and we can stop the spreading of the communicable disease also. Okay, so this is all about the communicable diseases in the human being. How it get transferred from the, or which are the ways in which the communicable diseases are getting spread. That is what, if the communicable diseases can get spread through air, water, food, with the help of the insects and animals also. So this is all about the communicable diseases in the human. Now we'll discuss about the communicable disease in animals.
So microorganisms can causes the communicable diseases in animals also and in plants also. So in animals like, we can say that there are the different animals like cow and the buffalo. Some microorganisms are causes diseases in them also. So it causes the diseases in the animals like cow and buffalo, and also poultry means what, we can say that hens. So because of the disease, what happened, the because of this disease, the production of the milk is get reduced. Also, it causes the, if it is severe, then it causes the death of the animals, and also it causes the growth, or it affects the growth of the birds. Okay, so in this way, we can say that what, communicable diseases can, microorganisms can causes communicable disease in animals also. Next one, we can say that what, the communicable diseases is also present in plant, or the microorganisms can also causes communicable diseases in plant. So there are the certain plants, like we can say the apple, oranges, potatoes, some fruits are there. In all these plants, some microorganisms are causes communicable diseases, and because of the communicable diseases, the production of the crops are getting decreases. But how the communicable diseases are get transmitted in the plants? So in the plants, the communicable diseases are getting transmitted with the help of the soil, air and water. So in this way, there are these certain diseases which are present in plants also. There are some types of the diseases is already given in the table 2.2. We can say that some examples, citrus cancer is there, rust of wheat is there, and the yellow vein mosaic of bhindi, or we can say that okra. All these are the some common diseases that we can see in the plant.
So if there are the communicable diseases, if the communicable diseases are spreading, then we can control the spreading of the communicable disease. We can stop the spreading of the communicable disease by doing certain types of the thing, or by following certain types of the precautions. First one, we can say that before eating the fruits and the vegetable, we should wash it thoroughly, or we should wash it properly. We should drink a boiling water when there is any natural calamities or during the rainy season, or I can say that every time we have to drink a boiled water only. Keep the infected person totally in the isolation. Isolation means what? Keep them alone, and whatever the belongings, whatever the material of that person, that also keep it properly. Don't allow anyone to touch that belongings. Next one is that
maintain the personal hygiene and the habit of sanitization. Sanitization means what? We should, whenever we are going to the washroom, we have to throw the enough water after coming from the washroom. You should wash your hands and the legs like that. We have to keep the good hygiene habits or the sanitary habits. Okay. Also, next one, very important, we should vaccine. The person or that baby should get vaccinated at the proper age to improve, to enhance the immunity against the particular disease. Next one is that maintain good sanitization in the community. Means it doesn't mean that we can keep our whole house clean and that whatever the garbage is there, we are throwing outside the road. It is not a good habit, okay? As we are keeping our house clean, we should keep our surrounding also clean. Next one, very important, do not eat any uncovered food. Always eat fresh and freshly prepared food. Next one is that protect yourself from the mosquito bite. You can use the mosquito net while sleeping, or also you can use the mosquito repellent cream to protect yourself from the mosquito bite. Next one is that do not allow any stagnant water in your surrounding. If possible, then destroy the breeding places of the mosquito, which helps to stop the spreading of communicable disease. And the last one is put fine wire mesh on the windows and on the door, which helps to or which allow avoid the entry of the mosquitoes in your house. And in this way, we can stop the entry of the mosquito in our house. So all these are the certain measures that we have to follow to stop the communicable diseases. So in this way, what we have seen today, we have discussed about harmful microorganism, how the harmful microorganism causes the communicable diseases in human being, in animals and in plant. So this is all about today. Today we will stop here. We'll meet in the next video, and for today, thank you.